What we're gonna work on now are trying to balance to our outside ski. Whenever we're skiing, this is a really critical skill because whichever ski has more pressure, in other words, weight, is the one that's in charge. And when we're skiing and we're skiing on our outside ski, if we're pushed off of that outside ski, it controls us. If we're balanced on it, we control it and it's in charge. So our goal here is to develop the ability to balance on that outside ski. The first drill we're gonna do is called a three-step. It's really simple. You can do it with your skis on or off, but you wanna do it in a flat spot. And all you're gonna do is you're gonna start on one foot and move three steps to the other side, pause on your other foot and balance. You only need to pause for long enough to know that you could stay there longer, and then you're gonna take three steps back the other way, pause on your new outside foot. As you do this, start to notice how you're balanced on that foot, the feelings under your foot, and that is exactly what you're gonna feel when you're in the fall line pointed downhill in the powder. It's gonna set us up to be balanced so that we can control that ski and move more easily through the turn. The second drill we're gonna do is called a ghost foot turn. Similar to the three step, it's gonna help us find the sweet spot for balance on our outside ski without trying to do something arbitrary to get there. What we're gonna do in a ghost foot drill is we're gonna make turns that are gonna look actually pretty normal, pretty similar to the turns you would make. However, one foot is gonna be ghosting. For example, just pick one foot and that foot's gonna stay really light on the snow for your entire set of turns, whether it's the inside or the outside foot. What that's gonna do is it's gonna train your other foot to stay in balance throughout the entire turn. The most common thing skiers do when they get in powder is they try to create force, extend their outside ski, and it knocks them off of balance inside the turn, and ultimately either the skis jet out or we spin uphill. What this drill is gonna do is it's going to keep us in balance by having the other foot be really light. You know you've done this well if you get to the bottom of the turns and your one foot that's working is really tired. If you're not tired, you probably haven't done it all the way. So try to keep your other foot, the one that's the ghost foot, really light so your other foot has to work. And finally, we're gonna do some drifter turns. Now that you've identified how to accurately balance on your outside ski, we're gonna use that a little bit more in motion. What we're gonna do is we're gonna make a series of medium-sized turns, and in those turns, we're gonna ski, start the turn, and then when we get our skis pointed straight downhill, instead of continuing to turn the other way, we're gonna let our skis drift sideways just a little bit before we finish that turn. That's gonna enable us to practice carrying momentum sideways in the powder and help us maintain some more flow as we ski through it. So again, we're gonna start with a medium-sized turn, and as our skis start to point downhill, instead of hooking up the edges and going across, we're gonna let them drift sideways out the side of the turn. For more tips like this, talk to your local PSIA certified ski instructor.